Morning.
Thanks, y'all too.
Well, well. This don't look like sunny tossing out of me. Woo-hoo! Hola, amigo.
How many days in Mexico?
Not enough. All right, so once again, Tanya and I just landed at the airport. So I'm headed across the street to Diego's Tacos to pick up our Jeep rental. The taxis here won't allow the car rentals to bring the cars inside to the airport. So we had to let them know that we'll meet them across the street. That's all right. What you gotta do. Yeah, they got some cold beer out here anyway, so that'll work. So this is a hola. I'm renting a Jeep from him, but you know what? He didn't bring me no damn cervezas, so I don't know if I'm gonna rent from him again.
Now we're stopping to get some beer. We're just kind of hanging out the neighborhood. Hola! It's beautiful here in Cozumel. This is the view from our condo. There's the pool down there, as you see. It's a nice, great pool. There's the ocean, the beach, the water, everything around us comes alive. It's so awesome. Breakfast this morning. We had a breakfast, so we're gonna head into town and have some breakfast with some friends.
Good morning. Let's go see Adam and Chris. Yep.
Sometimes when you're walking down for breakfast, just the aroma off the street gets you. You're like, what is that smell? And I turn around. Look at the size of these tortillas.
Wow, that is so awesome.
Highly recommend this place. The food is delicious. The atmosphere, the coffee is fabulous.
We're going on vacation with Addis.
We're going on vacation.
Hi. These are the girls that went to the breakfast this morning. Thank you.
Headed down to the Coletta, jumping on the boat. It's 11:45. We're doing afternoon dives. Ready for this, Deaver?
I'm ready. Ready to get wet.
It is very hot. Cannot wait to get in. Shove that regulator in my mouth and drop it. Down below, we had a Jeep earlier when we first got here. It wasn't.
It was not women.
There was no way at all. It was a two-door soft top, but we were going to take the top down. But now that we got this one, because the other one didn't run, the RPMs were real high on it, the steering was jacked up, it was a mess. So I made them give us this one. Can't take the top off completely, just the two here. We'll do that here in a day or two.
I couldn't drive it.
Yeah, Tanya couldn't drive it, so we got this. So, hola, senorita. I'm going to be diving with Scuba Tony.
And Marina Curato.
Mande?
In a buceo.
Vamos a ir a Scuba Tony. She's just checking
us out. Gracias, senorita.
Gracias.
Have a good day.
They're fancy at the Coletta.
There's the iguana in the road. Keep going.
Mr. Deaver just parked the car. Now we're going to go We didn't jump on the boat. We just had to park and come there in.
Whew, let's get wet. It's hot.
Wow, we know what
Hola.
Hola.
That's my look at you.
Let me see that.
Hello, Anna.
Have you done the raft?
I have not.
Would you like to?
I would love to.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's go. Let's do the raft.
The way I like to do this one is to go first the deepest part. I go around it a little bit and then kind of coming up, and then at some point getting inside a little bit and then again up, and then I like to enter from the back and drop all the way to the front and out, alright?
So tell me, Adam, how did you enjoy this dive?
Hey, this 2-for-1's back in the last all night.
That's a funny.
So we just finished our first dive. This is our surface interval. And we're just right here. There is the dock that we're at. And I'm gonna turn around and show you our beautiful view. We had a great dive.
Well, not the one, I think we're talking about the same thing.
Great, free.
No, but they have the hard shell.
This one in the sand, sometimes we see pipe moors or pipe fish, little animals over there.
Chiquita Bonita at the helm. We spent about 30 minutes looking for seahorses and some seagrass. We didn't find any. That's all right. That was at the end of the dive. We were just kind of off-gassing anyhow. So, and we met a girl named Anne from Australia. She dove the Great Barrier Reef for the last 2 years, and she was very impressed with diving here. So that says says a lot, obviously.
She said she's
girl.
Coming back.
We just dropped her off. She's staying in town in a little condo here. And we are headed back over here by the Barracuda Hotel in Orlando's to meet Adam and Chris for 2-for-1, buckets of beer, and some tacos.
Okay, this is Jeannie's. This is where we're having drinks after our dive. Just Adam, Chris, Ringle, and I. And this is our lovely backyard at the moment. And it's here. It's so peaceful.
Said to her straight up, "Hey, I'm not a floater, or I can't float. I can swim but I can't float.
Watch this. Now you're floating."
Then he goes, she goes, sink. And he goes, she goes, breathe out. He goes,
no, she goes like,
breathe out.
And his lungs are full.
And his lungs go, breathe out, man.
So we just left our place, went downtown, filled the Jeep up with gas, and now we're headed over to the east side of the island to fly the drone, get some breakfast.
Excellent day.
Orleans. He says he's got a great place on the island where he loves to go, and he's sharing with us that they got the probably the best mojitos on Cozumel. So I told him I was going to go down here. We're going to critique the mojitos and let him know how great they are.
We've arrived at the Open Bar 25 Hours Mojito Factory. Here it is, as you'll see, to taste test these mojitos.
Welcome to Miami.
Here, we all have some good mojitos here. Is there any treat to that?
Yes.
Huh? A friend of ours sent us this direction for the mojitos.
All right, Gary, here's a test of the mojito that you told us to come down here and find out about. Let's see. What do you think, baby? Is it good? She's a mojito queen.
I love mojitos.
You like it?
Yes, I've had a few mojitos in my time, and this is delicious. Thank you for the suggestion, Gary. We took you up on it.
No made in China.
No made in China, yeah. No way, it's made in Mexico, right here on the beach. It's delicious.
I am
professional. A professional mojito maker. We just left the condo. We're headed into town, and we are going to pick up Encarna and Tony for dinner. And we're on the waterfront. And up ahead of us, but you can't see it just quite yet, cruise ships are leaving. Yeah, they're really pretty.
It's so pretty. That's about the best thing about a cruise ship is when they're leaving. They do look pretty out on the water, though.
Flat juice margarita. This is great margaritas.
Scarf down some Mexican food.
And they had a little souvenir stand. Literally, it was like a little cart. Pancho's wife used to cook lunch for people. And so people would go. So people would come, and they heard that Pancho's mom would make lunch.
Right.
So they used to go into Pancho's backyard and have lunch. Into the backyard.
That's where we're at.
So,
it's going to be a nice day out on the reefs.
And rumor has it that the legend, the myth, Scuba Tony's going to be on the boat.
Kayla Bonita on her way in, picking up Tanya and I. Out there, we're going to go play with the fishies. It's going to be another good morning. Papo!
Hey, señor.
Hola!
So sorry.
Don't worry.
Thank you.
right now we're heading to El Cedral.
El Cedral, si. It will be the next dive.
Yep.
What was the first one that we done?
First one, we went through Palancar Bricks.
What all do we see there?
A couple of turtles.
Some pikefish, tiny ones, huh?
Yes, pipe horse. Yes. Yeah, a couple
they're
of those.
So small, I can't believe you can see them. They're so tiny.
Yeah,
I
me
need
too.
A magnifying glass for that.
But they are good. I like them a lot.
Israel's been leading dives down here with Tony for a long time, and Tanya and I absolutely love it when we're in the water with him. One of the best dive masters down here, working hard, him and Popo.
I am Mexican model, very handsome. I need a girlfriend.
Hi.
Lots of shopping here. Anything.
I see the people who are sitting and everything. If okay. I know the people, I come and talk to them, right?
That's yeah, well, that food was unbelievable. That
thank
was
you
a,
so
yeah.
much.
This is a nice store. What do you give you?
A little dolphin. I put it in my little trinket. Thank you. Yes.
You're welcome. And anything you like it in my store, I have 60-70% discount for you.
There you go.
For me, I'm telling one simple thing. For me, this is a very slow season.
Tell me what's your YouTube channel?
I don't have
YouTube. You don't have a YouTube channel yet? I bet someday you will, though, huh?
Yeah.
You sure are pretty. You're going to do good on YouTube. What's your name?
Sophia.
So what's up?
Sticks and rocks fall. Pretend I'm still torn, but it's that all I'm on. Choose the words that go like a razor. And all that I say, it's far away.
Here we are.
more turquoise, having some cocktails. Great ambiance here. We didn't get to watch any sunsets because we had a little rainstorm come in, but it was beautiful rain. And we had a good dinner.
So we just left our place before we had to pick up Adam and head out to the golf course.
I was like 60 yards out and the pin was behind, like right behind the sand trap, so I had to flop it and like hope that I landed straight down by the pin. It hit the flagpole and went right in the hole and I made it.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, it was so sick. What have you guys been doing today?
Went up to Coconuts, went over there, hung out for a little while.
I'm gonna teach Adam how to play golf. He says he's consistent 10 over par on course. We'll see.
10 over par. Like 15 over.
And I got you guys a little souvenir for you to remember today. It's in the golf cart in the little cup holder.
Okay.
Check it out. There's a little box right there.
So we got a gift from the PGA Pro Tour golfer here in Cozumel. Whoa! Oh man, are you kidding me? Oh my God. Look at that, honey. The Scuba Tony golf ball. You know it's official now.
Crazy.
I love it. Thanks, Adam. They were so cool. I'll never hit these. I'll end up.
We got the whole gang here now.
The whole gang. It's a four-person golf tournament. Only one person's actually playing there, and then you use it.
You find the flag and hit it with this.
Okay. It's in the hole, number four.
Hands on the wheel.
Hole number seven, 348 yards to the flag, par four.
We're about seven beers in.
Professionals up on the course getting his next shot lined up. This is what the spectators are doing. They're back by the golf carts drinking beer. I'm like, really? Come on, ladies, support the pro golfer Duffy up on there. Golf claps, golf claps.
And beer.
That was a perfect shot.
There's where that last tee shot landed. And there, behind that colorful tree, is the flag. 470 yards from the tee box to the flag. And we are standing probably about 150 to 70 yards.
Laser beam says 122 to the flag.
So that's a 300 yard tee shot. Dead center fairway. Very impressive, Mr. Duffy. Very impressive. Oh, that's got a lot of break in it right there. Get over in there. Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. The professional golfer, Mr. Duffy, is tearing up the course. We're going to take a break for a cigar smoke. Oh, man, Adam's a man of his word. I love it. Yeah, just one over par, five on the four. Drink it, Adam. You got it, baby. Yep, yep.
For the kid, all right. The red, white, blue. Who knew the kid would be everything from old
Show me what you're working with, Big AD.
Baby, I'm sick of getting ripped off. So pissed about to be the star. Mac and me.
Payback's a bitch.
What happened, Adam?
I set Randall up with a 5-foot putt and bet him a beer chug. If he missed it, and what happened?
I did miss the putt, but that's not the total truth. It wasn't a 5-foot putt, it was a 15-foot putt. So I'll go ahead and drink to that.
What? I don't think so.
You missed this putt. You're chugging a beer. I've already
well,
chugged one.
I get kind of hot, though. There's no way I'm missing this. It's way too close. Oh! Well,
5:15, whatever. It's a beautiful day in Cozumel, and I'm thirsty.
Hey, I chugged one. Now it's your turn.
Oh! It's hard on old man.
It's brutal. Gangster. Get low. Thank you very much.
Yeah, well, this ain't your typical PGA course. This is the way we do golf here. Got the jams going. And I'm walking up to the tee box. Let her rip, potato chip.
Get in the hole, get in the hole, get in the hole.
That's a good shot, Adam. That's a good shot, brother.
Right down the fairway.
There we go. Silence on the golf course. Kenny's not, of course, cooperating. He's back there singing. And the little breeze, and we got the flag girl moving. Oh, we missed it just by.
She hit the high notes.
Now this is pretty good here. You wanna take it? Last hole.
Okay, we just finished up 18 holes, and now we're gonna take a guess on what Adam's final score was. I'm gonna say he shot a 93.
Chris, what's your guess?
92.
98.
And Mr. Duffy?
85.
Is that the total? That's
yeah.
it?
Yeah, that's what I think. All right.
That's what he thinks.
Drum roll.
2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8, 9, 9, 10, 11. 11 is an 83.
Oh my God. That was 10 off. Wait, good job, Adam.
I said 83.
What's par?
72.
Tanya and I have been to Cozumel quite a few times. Never been to the golf course, but I got to tell you, this is a great day. Thanks, Adam. Thanks, Chris,
yes.
for inviting us.
Thank you.
Hello, guys.
What's your name?
I'm Tamara.
And where are we?
We are here in Cozumel, in the city of Punta Sur.
What's that?
We have lionfish pizza. It's lionfish. Good. We make our own beer. We have a very fine.
Lots of pizza, lots of beer. We got guacamole and we got a Spanish pizza, but the lionfish pizza is the most famous pizza on the island. My favorite spot. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We're headed to the other side of the island now to see Adrian.
Time to go have some fish tacos at Senior Iguanas.
And some ceviche.
And probably a cigar or two.
A little bit bigger, just there to the shade. Just right there in the shade near the palm tree.
Okay, so we just rolled in here. This is Eddie, our dear friend. He's been so kind to us through the years, Tanya and I. He's been working on this ranch out here.
For at least 5 years.
5 years. Yeah. He's been inviting me and Tanya to come out to take a look at it, and we're thrilled to be out here. This place is gorgeous. So Eddie's going to tell us a little bit about how he got started out here working. And this is Dixie.
That's Dixie. Let me tell you about the land. The land, all this land and all the homes actually belong to this family called Navarrete. Now they all have homes in town, and these are kind of second homes. And actually, when we started, this was all rock. You can't believe it. It was jungle.
You see the thick vegetation out there is pretty much what it looked like in here.
This property is called Ihadao.
That's actually
the government. It's like homesteading. They give the property to the local people.
Eddie built these swings for the grandkids. A lot of work in progress, but this place is awesome.
All these little mosaics and put their names on them.
Is this the grandkids' names?
Yeah. That's JC. He was the last one. I just added that one. This Lunita, she was the first, and Mammy, and then Bali, Dante, and JC.
What's the size of the property here?
Well, actually, each piece of property is 50 meters wide.
Okay.
and it goes back 1,000 meters.
Let's see the detail on the port, honey.
It's exquisite. It's clean. And the house is blessed.
Shutters on the windows. Now we kind of all pull up and they built these windows.
Man, I love the architecture of it, the design.
Look at this great kitchen.
It's a little hot in here because it's all closed.
Yeah, it's all closed. Oh, wow, that wall. That's so pretty, all that's bamboo.
No, it's a sapote wood. Sapote wood or something like that. Just some kind of hardwood.
I'm going to help Eddie tidy up a little bit, get his tools together, and then we're gonna head out of here and go down to Senior Iguanas. Gracias, amigo.
Quiet.
Got it going up there? Thank you, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
My name's Dave.
Dave Randall. My pleasure.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Even watching everyone.
It is. It's taking photos everywhere.
Now with Adrian, Alejandra over at Senior Iguanas. I got to tell you, though, looking at all this sargassum grass that just keeps blowing in, the seaweed, it's a little disheartening. I hope Mother Nature has a way of resolving this. This is just, from a diver's perspective, it's really not something you want to see going on in our oceans around the world.
When Randall and I were here a year ago, it was nothing like this. They just have difficulties cleaning it up.
Currents off Brazil. Coupled with the North Atlantic circulation has brought it up the east coast of Brazil into the Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico, where for the first time ever it met the right conditions to just take off, to explode. And those conditions are that the Gulf of Mexico and Caribbean Sea have a fever.
Hey, the sun's going down, so it's time to jump in the razor and tear this bitch up. Let's do this. Yeah.
So tell me again, Alfonso, what's going on? That's the razor turn.
Our main focus is to clean the beaches on this side. It's clean on that side, but it's very dirty on this side. Not too many people can get in there. So you're telling me
if you're doing the razor tours, when
razor
you get
tours and do cleanup tours there,
you have to do, pick up trash up there.
Yes.
That's unbelievable. That's
yes.
That's taking care of the planet and the island.
We're trying to get a machine out of the plastics that we get out of the beach to make chairs, to make plastic bricks, you know, for the environment, to make yourself an environmental house.
There's a lot of trash that washes up on these islands from the current.
They come from different parts of the world. China, Cuba, Haiti, you name it, Japan, we pick it up around the world. I wish they wouldn't do that. Kills our planet, kills our fish. There's plastic in human beings now that's being studied because of the fish that we eat. If people didn't know that, but I just barely knew.
That's a great way to get back to the environment. And it's people like Alfonso and his crew that are driving up there doing this that makes it better for the generations to come. My grandsons, your children, and everyone else.
The Lighthouse Project.
Get with him, honey. Look, she got two. Uh-oh. I'll
tell you what's fixing to happen.
We're fixing it.
Birthday boy on the island.
Birthday boy, a shot of
Don Julio.
Happy birthday, Alan.
Thank you, buddy.
Love you, baby. Here's to another 32 years.
Finishing up the end of the day. It's not the first time we closed Senior Iguanas down. Adrian's behind the bar. The crew's getting all the tables together. We got to lock this SOB up and get out of here and head back downtown.
So we just had another incredible day on island.
No, it wasn't incredible.
We don't get down here enough. There's so much to do. So we started off this morning, went and did a little snorkel trip around Jacques Cousteau, the epitome when it comes to scuba diving. Left there, went up north. Adam told me about a wall jump up there, so we went up there and hung out up there.
And of course, another adventure, because you know my husband's insisting on doing this and jumping off of this cliff. So that's where we're headed. So come on, let's go check it out.
Dove into there, played around.
And he's gone.
I don't know where the hell he went, but I heard a splash. That's a good thing. This is basically where the runway is, right behind us. Who knows what's on the other side of this wall? I can't see.
The water over there, because I'm fixing to run up this wall and jump off.
No.
Been on the island for 5 days and still have not made it out to see Adrian. After jumping off the wall, we left there and went over to the windward side of the island, over to the east side, and hung out with Adrian all day. The best fish tacos on the island. I tell people all the time, these are the best fish tacos you're gonna have. It's been a full day.
That's where we're headed. We're back on the back roads, heading into town.
Go ahead.
Oh man, I'm gonna go broke now.
So I stumbled across the hardest store here in Cozumel. And I think I may have made a mistake. Look at the wife over there. Yeah. And every time I turn around, I see her walking back over here. This is so far. What she's got. And he keeps selling to her. It's his fault. Small store. We were here in February. They didn't have anything. They had Cozumel on it, but now they got all kinds of stuff, so.
Yeah,
and the size, I think,
is for a girl. So this is
Larimar.
Yes. Wow, that is pretty.
It's
a pretty color, isn't it?
Yeah, that is pretty.
From the helm of Atina, this is Captain Beaver.
Let's go play with the giraffes and the elephants. Oh wait, wrong part of the water. Wrong support, Mark. Thank you.
Just finished up our twilight dive back on the boat for our surface interval, and then we'll head down for the night dive. Looking forward to it. Should see lots of cool stuff on the reef. These night dives in Cozumel are always a little extra special. This particular dive, I actually saw four or five lionfish on this dive. We normally don't see that many lionfish down here, so they were pretty good size too. Too bad I didn't have a spear. We could have eliminated them. But other than that, I saw three turtles, big snapper, saw two clinging crabs. So yeah, it was quite a bit. It was a good, nice, relaxing dive. I don't think we got any deeper than 53 feet, 54 feet. So just kind of cruise along with the current.
Oh, yeah. That's all he did. When at the first 6 months I worked for Scuba Tony, all he did was play tricks on me. I left my fins in his car once.
Uh-huh.
There's about 20 girls all standing outside a bar. So I've jumped out and said, oh, you've got me fins. He went, yeah, I'll come and get them like that. And then as I got to open the door, he drives the car a bit further. And then a bit further, and then I'm just chasing him down the street.